Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jump.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm worn out. I've been spending the last hour trying to get this pivot table to do what my manager wants me to do. And I think I'm pretty smart. I mean, I've got myself Mr. Excel, right? I mean, is it able to change these headings from sum of revenue to revenue space and put in a percentage of the total? I tried to choose some formats here to make it look good. But you know, these percentages of the total are like, there's no way to get this 204 as a percentage of the 599. Just cannot happen. It's always the 204 as the percentage of the grand total. And I'm just so frustrated with this. Okay, but let's use that cool Microsoft trick that we've been talking about the last couple of days, the GetPivotData. So I inserted a new sheet and I created a nicely formatted report how I want it to be formatted. Look at this. The word East repeated all the way down and Central repeated all the way down and West repeated all the way down. And I even put in my percentage of region calculation, which the pivot table can't seem to do. Now, how are we going to make this come to life? I'm going to take the equal sign, go back and point into my pivot table. This is ABC East. So I go to ABC East. There's my number right there. And that's going to build the get pivot data formula for me. But now I'm going to go through and parameterize this. So where it says region East, I'm going to say that I always want to grab that from $A6. And where it says product ABC, I'm going to parameterize that and say that's always going to come from $B6. All right, good. And so now I can copy that down. See, look how it works. And then I'm going to copy it over here where I had created a field called percentage of total. So percentage of total instead of revenue. Doesn't like that. Must have been percentage of total without a space. There we go. All right. Beautiful. Now, I wonder if instead of literally typing the value in there, if I could point to a cell, wouldn't that be cool? Of course, you know, I didn't do it that way because it doesn't work. So undo. You actually have to type the name in there. Well, all right, we can live with that. I'll format that nicely, and of course, we can copy that down. And then I also had a field called GP percent. So I'll come back here and change the percentage of total to GP percent. All right, get those GP percents. Now that we have that whole table working, we can copy it, paste it, and we are ready to roll. All right, so now, what are the advantages? Well, I am using a pivot table here, so as I change the underlying data, I can come back to my pivot table, I can refresh, and the pivot table will be refreshed. But then, the actual printed report is going to come from this page. And the nice thing here, people say, well, you know, from month to month, my pivot table loses its formatting, or all kinds of bad things like that. Well, this isn't going to lose its formatting because it's just straight Excel. All right, but we get to take advantage of GetPivotData to reach into the pivot table, grab those values. So it's really kind of the best of both worlds. We're using all of the power of the pivot table, but we're not stuck with any of those stupid limitations that they give us. You know, back here in the pivot table, if I wanted to insert a column between C and D, no deal, can't do it, not allowed. If I come out here outside of the pivot table, insert column, cannot move a part of a pivot table, yada, yada, yada. Yeah, I get it. Okay. But over here on my report, yeah, sure. You want a column here? No problem. Let's just put a tiny column in. It doesn't matter because it's just Excel. You know, and so I added a field up here for quarter one and then build a second report here where I'm grabbing that parameter from B1. So, you know, we can change this to be quarter two or quarter three. And now very quickly get a brand new report. So lots of very, very cool things. I'm starting to see why the folks at Microsoft have been using GetPivotData. You know, and I think for most of the rest of the world, we hate it. We wish it would get turned off. But once you start to understand how it works, I can see a lot of the power of GetPivotData. Now, one thing to be aware of here is that the value that you're trying to get must be visible in the pivot table. So if I go back to my pivot table here, I can imagine something where we would want the ABC total without regions. And since that number is not visible in the pivot table, it's not going to be available to us in GetPivotData. Seems to be a bit of an annoying limitation. So that's actually 2 days ago when I started this whole conversation, I created a pivot table where I just put everything in hopes then that any number I could possibly need, get pivot data, will be there. All right, so there you have it. End of 3 days talking about get pivot data. Started out with hate get pivot data, understand get pivot data, and now I start to see where there might be some nice uses for get pivot data, a pretty interesting function. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.